Alright, hey guys. So today we're going to be doing a scapular wing. So it's a scapular control mechanism. So trying, not looking for a one singular discrete muscle, but looking for general scapular control and disassociation between scapular movement and humeral head movement. So let's have a look. So we're looking for here, at a bench around about knee height. You can do this freestanding, but a bench usually makes life easier. Nice straight line through the back, and just getting a comfortable setup here, okay? So from here, we're gonna take one hand off, relax it down to the ground, and your first movement is looking at scapular retraction. So as you can see, my hand hasn't gone backwards or bent or done anything else this way. It's just a straight vertical plane of movement with the scapula moving medially towards the spine. So from here, using that same musculature on the inner aspect of the shoulder blade to lift the arm up in place. Now the arm, you can see, is a bit of a dead weight. So I'm not tensing or flexing anything. It's just all even behind the shoulder blade. So from here, this is the challenging part. Try and keep the medial border, this inner aspect of the shoulder blade, still as we lower the arm down. So looking at moving the arm, but not the shoulder blade as we go. And then relax down. So the movement as a whole should look like this. Scapular retraction. Arm up to the side, holding everything in place firmly as the arm goes down, and then relax at the end. So you should feel the scapula move away from its centralized held position once you relax. All right, have a go at this one, and we'll see you guys next time.